Hi everyone, welcome to this short demo video where we will show how Surfly can be used for a kiosk use case with NICE's CXOne. So let's jump straight into the demo. So on the left here, I have NICE's Max interface for the agent. And on the right, I have a quick landing page that we've made to mimic a customer kiosk. So agent on the left and customer on the right. So as an agent, I can make myself available. And then as the customer, what I'll do is I'll come in and I'll interact with the kiosk. And then we see a Surfly loading screen here. This can be configured on and off. You can brand Surfly to your own colors, your own branding, and completely white label the user experience. So I'll change my inputs as the customer. I'll mute my microphone, and I'll use a looping video of our CEO to represent the customer, and I'll click join. The incoming interaction creates a work item in Max, which I can accept as the agent. So again, this load screen can be configured on and off as you need. I'll be the agent myself and I'll join the call. So now we're in a video conversation. The agent and the customer are speaking, having a conversation. It's important to note that we have a few options for display here. So what I can do is I can make this screen a little different. So I can see only the person I'm speaking to and then a preview of myself in the corner. And I can also have both participants or all participants, however many there might be, all shown together. When we're speaking over video, perhaps we decide that there will be more value browsing the web together or perhaps editing a document. So I'll show you how you can do this. So what I can do as the customer here, I can open a new tab and I can enter a URL. Now I'm entering a web page, but this can also be a web app or anything that can be run on a browser at all. So I'll click browse URL. And then we enter into a co-browsing session. So the first thing you'll see as I scroll as the customer that the scrolling is matched on the agent side. From the agent side, I can annotate the screen and guide the customer through whatever they're doing. So I can say, for example, scroll back up and the customer will do that. My annotations scroll with the page. And then as the agent, I can perhaps direct them to a particular part. So I'll say, hey, click view a demo. And the customer will click view a demo. While we're navigating, control can of course be passed between participants. So if one person wants to navigate and the other wants to annotate, you can switch back and forth as you need to. Now that we come to the viewer demo page, there's a form I have to fill out here. So as the customer, I can start entering my information. And you will notice that on the agent side, that when we get to job title, I actually, as the agent, can't see what the customer is entering here. So this is done by element masking. So you can mask buttons, you can mask input fields, whatever you need to hide from the agent, perhaps so the customer can feel more confident entering maybe sensitive information depending on your use case. This is something you can do with element masking. So that's how we can browse together, but there's a few other features I'd like to show you as well. For example, we can also share screen, perhaps if we need to do that, but we can also upload files where we can edit them together. So I will select Surfly's Ultimate Guide to Co-Browsing to bring into our document editor, where the customer and I can now edit things together. So once the document loads, we can browse together. And again, scrolling is matched in the same way as before. We are able to edit text, annotate, do whatever we want, essentially. There's some intuitive navigation options, so we can quickly jump to different pages. For example, we could jump to the end of the document if we had to. And I'll use this page here. And another thing we can do is, for example, sign documents. So I can click to add a signature. I can sign it here. And then I can place the signature on the document where it can then be downloaded and stored for later use. Once we're done with the document, we can go back to the co-browsing session, or we can go back to the video as we need to. So in this session, the full scope of Surfly's functionality is available and of course highly configurable. So you can create the journey that works best for you by enabling the features that you need. And if at some point in the conversation, the agent needs to bring in a colleague or perhaps the customer wants to invite somebody else with a stake in the conversation, we can easily do that too. So we can add participants and they can be invited over email, SMS, or perhaps another channel if that's what you require. When the conversation's done, either party can end the session. So I'll do it as the customer here. I'll click end for all. And that's it. The session is over. So that's everything for initiating a Surfly session in the NICE CXOne interface from a customer kiosk. For more information on Surfly and its capabilities, or for questions about the Kiosk implementation specifically, please reach out to nice@surfly.com and we'll be happy to answer your questions. Thanks for watching.